Daar zeilde op de Noordzee wijd en koud. Een schip zo zwaar beladen met s'werelds ijdel goud. Daar kwam de Spanjaard dreigend te roven ons het goud. Toen we voeren op de Noordzee, al op de Noordzee wijd en koud. Het was onze jongste makker, een jongen sterk en koen. Die sprak al tot een schipper, wat zult gij aan mij doen? Wanneer ik wil gaan zwemmen en ginds een Spaans galjoen. Doen zinken in de Noordzee, al in de Noordzee.
On the business greeting, this is of utmost importance. The first thing in the business greeting to understand is the business card itself. You know, in China, if you don't have a business card, it's like not having a name. Now, how do you give a business card to somebody? This is of extreme importance. When you take a card or give a business card, you need to be standing up and you need to use two hands. You offer any kind of gift from 5,000 years ago to now, this was sort of the methodology. If you're offering a gift to somebody, you use two hands to offer it. And a business card is the same way. You use two hands to offer your card. And it would be extremely disrespectful if you did not take another Chinese businessman's card with two hands. If you just grabbed it with one hand like this, it would be extremely disrespectful. Negotiation in China is a little bit different from what it is in the United States, and you need to understand that. Whoever you're dealing with wants to feel that he has come out on top. That means there has to be some room for negotiation. You can't just give somebody a price and expect them to take that price. Expect them to negotiate. And they will feel good only if they have negotiated and feel that they've won. You know, this whole win-win concept we have in the West, well, the Chinese like it to be, I win, okay? So in order to do that, you need to come in with a price that is expected to be negotiating. If you're trying to sell something, come in with a high price and expect them to cut it down. Give them some leverage to cut it down. If you're talking to the owner of the company, he wants to cut it down just to save money. If you're talking to somebody who's a manager in the company, then it's even more important because it's very, very important to his position in the company for the boss to feel that he saved money for that company. Now, how to use the chopsticks? Let's talk about this just for a minute. The first thing I'm doing wrong is I'm using my left hand. I happen to be left-handed, and there are no Chinese people who are left-handed because from the time they are young, they are forced to write and to eat with their right hand no matter what hand they use naturally. So you will always see Chinese people eating with their right hand, and because you're a foreigner, it's okay if you eat with your left hand like I do. Now, how do you use the chopstick? The first thing you do is set the first piece in your hand. Now, it doesn't move. It's solid. It goes between your index finger and your thumb, and then rests on your ring finger here, and it doesn't move, it's very tight. What moves is the other piece of chopstick. Now this, most Westerners don't understand. They believe that both pieces are moving. Between your thumb and your two fingers here, you can just move it back and forth, move speech. Normally, when you have a toast, you would just toast a specific person, like any time during the meal. Sometime during the meal, if President Zhang were sitting here next to me, I would just raise my glass to President Zhang and say, President Zhang, it's really nice to be with you this evening. Just something very simple, very nice, and then to touch glasses together. When you touch your glasses, it's important that you drop your hand a little bit so the rim of your glass touches below, so onto the body of his glass. So it shows that you're humble and inferior to him. Pull your glass down. Many, many Western business people have walked out of a meeting with Chinese businessmen believing that the deal was closed, when in fact it wasn't. Often, Chinese people will agree with you. They will nod their heads, they will give you indications that they agree, they will say yes, but that doesn't necessarily mean that they agreed. Because the contract, it just didn't mean much. So, for me to understand that real commitment is what matters. You know, to the Chinese person, face is important. Making a verbal commitment, really saying that I'm going to do this and here's how we're going to move forward, well, that's important to them.
May I help you?
We'll be asking the questions, old man. Who are you?
You.
No, not me, you.
Yes, I am you.
Just answer the damn questions. Who are you?
I have told you.
Are you deaf?
No, you is blind.
I'm not blind, you blind.
That is what I just said.
You just said what?
I did not say what. I said you.
That's what I'm asking you.
And you is answering.
Shut up. You.
Yes?
Not you, him. What's your name?
Me.
Yes, you.
I am me. He's me. And I'm you.
And I'm about to whoop your old ass, man, because I'm sick of playing games. You, me, everybody's ass around here. Him.
Kaja,
I'm going to kick his ass. I'm sick of it.
Let me
handle this. No, Lee, no.
Kaja.
Mr. Lippert. People from Matsushima are here.
Oh, yeah. All right. Tell them I'll be right there. Oh, man. Well, this is it, Blade. You know, without this merger, we'd be out on the street. Boy, they sure saved us.
We forgot our hamburger.
Mr.
Lippmann, it is with great pride that we undertake this partnership with your company.
I'm sorry. I can't shake your hand right now. It's gerbs.
No, I... 本当に失礼なことして、この大切な時は仕事をダメにしまった!